If I was going to increase more hydrogen gas yield, what would I do?
Increase the voltage.
Huh?
Increase the voltage in it.
Yes, now how would I do that? Would I need to change the pulsing circuit here?
Oh, just change the amplitude of it.
All I have to do here is just increase the number of turns of this coil, would I not? So since the diode now is acting as a switching diode, once you terminate the pulse, it opens up the pulsing circuit and now allows these magnetic fields to collapse. And when they collapse, now we're producing a unipolar voltage field across the capacitor, but in the process, we are restricting amps. Now note, we are using the electromagnetic field to restrict the amps, not a resistive element. We are using the electromagnetic field to restrict the amps, not a resistive element.
What order of frequency are we talking about? Do you this?
No, we go from 0 up to 10 kilohertz. Even with this type of circuit you see here, if I hit this at 10 kilohertz, would this not increase it to 20 kilohertz? So not only is this a pulsing circuit to restrict amp flow, it's also is a frequency multiplier. And guess what else? Okay, now what we're doing is that this circuit is not only now restricting the amps, but we are now pulsing and adjusting this pulse frequency to tap into the resonant properties of water by the dielectric value of water. And as a result, that when you tune into this, then what happens, amperol drops down to the lowest value and voltage now takes off towards infinity if the electronic components will allow it to curve.